morning students, welcome to today's class. Before beginning with the class, let's have a look at the thought for the day. And today's thought is, the time is always right to do what is right. Now many of you might have seen people procrastinating their work, saying that this is not the right time to do it. So today's thought, it motivates us saying that if you are intending to do right things, if you are trying to do good things, correct things, then never wait for the time. There is no special or appropriate time for doing right things. Right things can be done at any time, and that time when you are doing right thing, it becomes the right time. So, my advice to you all, dear, is that don't wait for the time. Keep doing your actions, keep trying from your side, and then you will see that whatever time you did the things, that time was the most appropriate time for you to carry on with the work that you had done. So, with this note, let's begin with today's class. So class, today we are going to start with a new chapter, The Rat Trap, by Selma Lagerlöf, from your Flamingo book. Now to know some things about the writer, she is a Swedish writer, right, who has written stories and Swedish language, but her stories have been translated to many different languages. So this shows that how popular the writer had been. She is also a Nobel Prize winner. Now in this story, The Rat Trap, we are going to learn about first thing that we should know before reading the chapter is about the Sweden, the country. Right? Now it is talking about the change. The change that was coming in Sweden during the second half of the 19th century. And what was the change? But prior to this, this country, Sweden, was an agricultural country. But slowly, while it came, it reached towards the second half of the 19th century, it started changing into industrial economy. Right? The agricultural country started changing into industrial country. So a place that is Värmland, where the story is also based, which we are going to read, then talking about that place, that Värmland was situated in the western Sweden and it was well forested and rich in iron ores. So because of this things, what had happened, this industry, Värmland started becoming an industrial. So this is the background of the story that it is giving, and because of this shift from the agricultural to industrial country, we see the changes, we see the sufferings that the people had faced, right? Many farm families, that is many families of the farmers, how they had to leave the place and go from that place. Because their land was taken up for industry. And some who were there, how they were facing poverty. So this story is trying to give us an insight through the country during this shift of things, during the changes in the country. The main character in the story is an worker. He is an iron worker, right, who is working in a factory but who loses his job, right, and then what things he does, what happens with him, let's study in the lesson. Once upon a time, there was a man who went around selling small traps of wire. Talking about the protagonist, talking about the hero of the lesson. So what was his work? he was a salesman. He used to sell rat traps. I hope you all know what is a rat trap. It's a trap. It's like a cage wherein which is used to catch mice. Okay. He made them himself at odd moments from the material he got by begging in the stores or at big farms. Now, what was the specialty of these rat traps? These rat traps were built, were made by this iron worker. And where did he get the material for making them? The writer says that he got the material from begging. Yes, begging. And why begging? Because he could not earn enough money, so many a times he took up for begging and also sometimes stealing, robbing. But even so, the business was not especially profitable, so he had to resort to both begging and petty thievery to keep body and soul together. So he says, even though he worked hard, right, in the factory, but this was not sufficient. He could not earn proper money through this, so he had to take up begging and thievery, robbing, stealing, to keep up his body and soul, to survive. Right? What is the meaning of the proverb? It is to survive. Even so, his clothes were in rags, his cheeks were sunken, and hunger gleamed in his eyes. So, in spite of working as an iron worker, begging, stealing, robbing, still his face did not have that glow. Why? Because he did not, after doing so many things also, he was unable to earn money in order to have good food. And that's the reason why he was with dull face. He did not have enough money to eat. Then where is the matter of buying dress or buying clothes would come? So that shows that how this man, the central character of the lesson, is utterly poor man. No one can imagine how sad and monotonous life can appear to such a vagabond who plods along the road, left to his own meditation. So the writer says we cannot imagine, people like you and me who are reading this, we cannot imagine the sufferings, the hardships that this man would be facing or would be going through. So life cannot appear to such a vagabond. Now we cannot imagine how boring, how sad, how dull life can be to such a man. Such a man who is a vagabond. Vagabond is what? A person who keeps wandering, who doesn't have proper place to live or who doesn't have a proper job. And because he does not have a proper job, he keeps moving here and there aimlessly. But one day, this man had fallen into a line of thought which really seemed to him entertaining. So one day when he was wandering, he fell into chain of thoughts. That is, continuous thought process. He started thinking continuously, one after the other, one after the other. The thoughts were coming to his mind. And which he really liked it. He was enjoying it. He had been naturally off his rat traps when suddenly he... he was struck by the idea that the whole world about him, the whole world with its lands and seas and cities and villages, was nothing but a big rat trap. So when he was getting all these ideas after ideas, one of the ideas that he got was that this entire world, all the oceans, all the seas, all big cities, small villages, towns, everything around him was nothing but a big rat trap. Rat trap is small. Why? Because small. small little mouth has to be trapped in that. But when you talk about the world, it will really become a very big trap, right? A very big cage wherein all people are trapped. It had never existed for any other purpose than to set baits for people. And what is the purpose of the world to exist? Its only purpose is to catch hold of its prey. What is a bait? A bait is like, if you have seen, to catch a bigger animal, there has to be placed some food so that that animal gets attracted and he comes and eats. So that food which is placed there, that is what is bait. When you go for fishing, you put your fishing rod inside the water, what is there? You put the food in the hook and attracted towards which the fish comes and she is trapped. Same way in the rat trap, what do? We put a piece of cheese or a biscuit or any other eatable items, and then the rat comes thinking that there's a food for it, and what happens? As soon as he enters into it, he is trapped, he is caught. So same is the condition with the world, he says, with the man in the world, he says. It offered riches and joys, shelter and food, heat and clothing, exactly as a rat trap offered cheese and pork. And as soon as anyone let himself to be tempted to touch the bait, it closed in on him. And then everything came to an end. So, for an animal to catch food, you use different food items. But for human being to get trapped in the world, what are the baits for him? It is like riches and joys, all the luxuries, all the happiness. Then shelter and food, heat and clothing. So all these things, what are these? These are the basic necessity. Food, shelter, clothes. All these are basic necessities. And when man tries to fulfill these basic necessities of himself, he is trapped. He is trapped into the world, into the rat trap that is known as world. Right? If he wants to fulfill all these necessities, he has to work hard, doing right things or doing wrong things. Whatever. It is only to fulfill my need. Why do we think? Why do we have those murderers, those smugglers, thieves? Because they want to fulfill their basic needs. Along with that, they also want to have some luxuries in their life. And then we come across a poor beggar. He is begging. People scold him. People say bad about him. And they ignore. They shout. But then why is he bearing all this insult? In order to fulfill his basic needs. So, from a person to person, this trap, this bait varies. And once you are trapped into it, you are gone. The world comes to an end there. You cannot come out of it. The world had, of course, never been very kind to him. So it gave him unwanted joy to think ill of it in this way. Now, what does the writer say? The writer says that the world had never given this iron worker, this man, anything good in his life. So he always enjoyed unwanted joy, unusual happiness. He got happiness in thinking bad about world. He was enjoying it. He was rejoicing in his thoughts. It became a cherished pastime of his during many dreary ploddings to think of people he knew who had let themselves be caught in the dangerous snare. So now the writer says, thinking bad about the world, thinking like world is a cage, is a prison, is a rat trap, this gave him a lot of happiness. And he would spend a lot of time in this. It became his favorite pastime. And he would think about the during many dreary ploddings. Dreary is what? It is depressing or dull. Plodding is unexcited. So during his dull, unexcited life, he would think about the people whom he had seen, caught themselves in the dangerous snare. Snare is again a trap. It's made out of wire. Right? So he had seen those people getting trapped into this snare. And of others who were still circling around the bay. And he had also seen some people who are still circling, still moving around that bait. Maybe thinking whether to get it or no, or waiting for a right time to get that bait. Either way. So in doing so, they are moving round and round around that bait. One dark evening, as he was trudging along the road, he caught sight of a little grey cottage by the roadside, and he knocked on the door to ask shelter for the night. So as we've already seen, he's a jobless and a homeless person. So one night when he's walking on the road, he comes across a cottage and he thinks of taking a shelter there. So with this thought, he knocks at the door. Nor was he refused. So when he asked for a stay at home at that cottage in that night, so he was welcome. He was not refused. Instead of the sour faces which ordinarily met him, the owner, who was an old man without wife or child, was happy to get someone to talk to him too in his loneliness. Now what are you saying? Instead of the sour faces, you remember, he's a salesman who sells his rat traps, and in doing so he might be going from door to door. And how do we behave when the salesperson comes to our place? Are we always friendly? Do we always welcome them? No. So that's what he is saying here. That's what he exactly wants to portray here. Right? And then he says, so all those faces who were not welcome, he was not welcomed by them, he was not liked by them. But here, this old man who opened the door, he welcomed him. And he was happy to get this guest at his place. Why? Because he was a man without family. And since he was a man without family, he really liked to have someone at his place with whom he could talk. And his loneliness, maybe for some time, would be gone. Immediately he put the porridge pot on the fire and gave him supper. Then he carved off such a big slice from his tobacco roll that it was enough both for the stranger's pipe and his own. So this old man seems to be really very kind. Right? A very good host. Without even the iron worker asking for food or anything, he offered him food. After his supper, after his dinner, he also shared his tobacco with him. And then what happened? Finally, he got out an old pack of cards and played majolis with his guest until bed. So after dinner, after taking tobacco and all, smoking tobacco and all, what did he do? He took out an old pack of cards. I hope you all understand what is cards. Yes, and then they started playing a game, that is majolis. So that's a card game which is played in Sweden. Till they both fell sleepy. So till that time, late in the night, they were playing cards. The old man was just as generous with his confidences as with his porridge and tobacco. So old man was very generous. He was very kind in sharing his porridge and his tobacco. And he says that old man was similarly generous with his confidence. He was very confident. Though he was old, though he was alone, he was lonely, but he never lost his confidence. He was still showing those signs of confidence in him. The guest was informed at once that in his days of prosperity, his host had been a profiter at Ramsujo's iron works and had worked on the land. So the guest was informed. Who's the guest? Yes, the iron man. And who's the host? The old man. So this old man started telling about his life. And in the olden, in his young youthful days, what did he do? He was working as a profiter. Now who's a profiter? It's a person who works in the farm. Croft. It's a small piece of land wherein you may be growing vegetables or some grass for the cow and buffalo. So that is what is a profiter. And then he says when he was no longer able to do the labor, day labor, it was his cow which supported. So he says when now that he had started growing old and he could not do that long labor, hard labor, then what was the thing? The cow that he had, it started supporting the old man. And then yes, that bossy was extraordinary. Bossy here is referring to the cow. She could give milk for the creamery every day, and last month he had received all of 30 kono in payment. So he says yes, the cow is such a good cow, such efficient cow, that every day it gives a lot of milk that can be carried to the creamery. Creamery, it is a place where the butter and cheese is made, right? And he says through this, with the help of this cow, he had earned last month how much? 30 kono, and in a payment. So what is kono? It's the currency of Sweden. It's the monetary currency of Sweden. So we stop here for today's class. In the next class, we'll see how further things proceed and what was the thing that iron worker had to face in coming future. Until then, keep learning, keep studying, keep experiencing. Take care.